So what's it like being a part of a hit Netflix show?
Fun.
All right.
Is that a good answer?
This is What a Joke
with Tom Papa and Fortune Feimster
on Netflix is a joke radio.
Season 2 of Black Summer, and you're amazing in it.
Thank you.
Very scary.
It's very scary.
All zombie things have a little darkness to it. And I, as a comedian, whenever I see these films, and I'm always, your breath gets taken away. You're like, is it that intense to actually shoot these films?
Yeah.
Is it?
I rely solely on comedy to get me through it. Like, really? It was like Anna Gadsby, Sam Jay, I can go on and on. Like, there were certain comedians that truly got me through, because when you're in it, it's so real. Like, what we're doing is so, it's not just like a zombie show, right? Like, that's really the mask.
Right. Right.
Or what it we're doing and what we're saying, you know?
Yeah. And it's a lot about a loss of control. It's when your reality gets flipped on its head and all the old rules and all the ways that you survive no longer are relevant.
Yeah. I mean, we're just trying to explore humanity. If these people are in this situation, what does a commodity mean? What does it mean if money doesn't matter? It's about food and shelter and water and trust and what happens when you have a collective trauma, right? And
right.
Like, who you band with, what, where is your integrity? What is your character? What is your, like, how do you operate within that thing? So it's like the show is very deep, you know? Yeah.
I don't think you can stay.
Why not? Please?
I don't know if you're useful.
I can't go back out there. I can't. I'll die. Please, I'll help you.
We need help dumping the bodies. Can you do that?
Yeah. You know.
I'm gonna get inside and make a fire. It's cold.
We were the first up for Netflix during COVID. So we were shut down, then we're the first up. Wow. And then first to make it through COVID clean. And I knew it. Like, I knew it as the producer. I was like, okay, listen, like, if anyone can do it, we can do it. Our cast, our crew, like, we're like,
yeah,
symbiotic, right? And
yeah,
and that energy is brought forward within our show, you know, because we do, you know, from like 7 to 20+ minute oners, you know, where we never cut the camera.
Wow.
And we have the blueprint every day, but then we throw our scripts on the ground. And we rewrite everything. We strip back everything. And we want to give everything to the audience so that we're not telling you how to think, feel, see, all of those things.
It's an interesting way to work, because there's something about being in this moment that artistically, we're kind of finding it as you're going. Anybody that writes or performs or does or creates shows or acts, you know that almost the old rules, like, some of it will still pertain, but we're moving in this new direction, so you almost have to be open to what you're feeling and what the people around you are feeling.
The joy meets the absolute fear, because when I say we're throwing a script on the ground, I'm not kidding, like, that's literal. We know the circumstances, the structure, and now what?
Yeah.
How we taking away. And then how do you do that in one shot where there's only one chance? And so, like, I really felt my own, like, with this, but so amazing. And I think that's why we're all artists, is that it's not just me playing someone else. There's mm-hmm. no, like, the playing is the play, right? The play is, like, in the freedom right. of being on set or being in the moment. That's the play, right?
Right.
But it is me and Rose merged, right? So it's sure. like playing it anything other than trying to get more nuanced and trying to get more connected and trying to be free enough inside of our own selves so that people can see themselves inside of us.
A Black Summer, which releases tomorrow, June 17th.
Oh my God.
Netflix.
It comes out tomorrow.
You didn't realize? Oh yeah. Here comes the pressure.
This is like the love of my life. This project is the love of my life. And so I think I've been like in a weird COVID denial about like what year is it? What month is it? What day is it?
Yeah.
Oh my
God. Yeah. Here it comes.
The thing is, I'm trapped in this. I'm somebody else now. And it doesn't matter if I like who that person is or not. It's who I am. I can only look out for her. No one else. It is crystal fucking clear. My life has one meaning, and it's her. So everybody else can just get the fuck out, because you're probably going down.
Well, I can't.
Well, welcome. It's a great show. It's,
Thank you. It was interesting shooting it. I mean, during the pandemic, I keep saying that there wasn't much acting involved. You know, right. It wasn't hard to put yourself into places where a virus spread it across the entire world. You know, when we got shut down for COVID, I was at like customs trying to come back in, and you know how they grill you with all the questions, and then what are you doing here? And I was like, I was shooting in Canada, and they were like, what are we shooting? A Netflix show. What's it about? A worldwide pandemic where people die and turn into zombies. The guy just gave me the coldest look, like, yeah, get out of here.
Now, you don't play necessarily a good guy in the series.
No.
I would say, just because you're here with us, I would call him complicated.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. He's complicated. He's morally ambiguous.
Yeah.
He's definitely not a great guy, I think, you know, when civilization was normal. But now that we've gotten kind of thrown into this apocalypse, and, you know, money and whatever doesn't matter anymore. All that matters is surviving. I think, you know, then there's some anti-hero-ness that comes out of him, just because he knows how to survive and he's a tough dude, you know, so he uses that to help himself and reluctantly others, I think, sometimes.
Jaime was talking about how a lot of times you guys would show up on set and basically toss the script to the side if something was happening, and you would start to improvise and go in different directions.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, the amazing thing is our showrunner, who's also the director of almost every episode, he's in the moment kind of guy, you know, and he really encourages us. He was like, hey, if you don't think you'd say that line, toss it. You know, which you know, most directors don't ever say, you know. And he just wants you to explore. He wants you to find it, you know. What he always says is he comes to set with an idea, hoping that people will make the idea better. You know,
right.
So he's really about collaborative and collaboration.
A very physical show too, right?
Oh yeah, very physical, very physical. You know, and particularly this season, he wanted it to be as much about fighting nature as it is zombies. You know, so I have one of my own episode, and where they just kind of track my character, and you know, it's very Revenant was kind of like the inspiration. In fact, we shot the same place where they shot the Revenant.
No. Yeah.
So it was real deal. I'm telling you, we were in like negative 10, negative 14 degree weather.
Thank you.
it was awesome because I didn't have to act sometimes. Yeah. Oh, right. Like I was really surviving. I'm, you know, I'm a Cali dude. So like born and raised, yeah. I don't know weather like that. And so, you know, I had like 4 or 5 layers on. I had big boots, you know, but it just added to the physicality of it, you know, and as you kind of trudging through the snow and, you know, I'm really fighting to keep warm, you know, see, just let the camera roll. Yeah. Justin's really trying to stay warm here. <You know? laughs>